Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to The Lockup Live. It's Friday night and your weekend starts here. Over the past few weeks, you've kept us on air by donating. Don't be shy yet again tonight because we want to bring you the best in Irish music and entertainment. Tomorrow night, we've got the High Kings, but tonight we've got a special treat for you. A man who started off music at a very early age playing the fiddle at 7 and then worked his way to be a dancer with Riverdance at the age of 15. He toured for years and at the age of 20 decided, I'm going to come home and do the thing that I love most. Playing music. While it's busking on a street, he was picked up by a brilliant manager and he became one of Ireland's best singer-songwriters. He's still that to this day. And tonight, you have the great pleasure of seeing him on The Lockup Live. Tell your friends and get donated. Right now, ladies and gentlemen, this is Ryan Sheridan.
Too high, now we got nothing left to show.
Can't see it's gonna be alright. There's no heat from a dying light. But we carry this torch for far too long. A deep breath is the way it goes. You can't breathe if your heart is closed. Can't fix what's broken now, it's gone.
Great to be here. Thanks everybody for checking in and tuning in. And we're going to try and give off as much energy as we possibly can and bring it to you at home. So this next song we're going to play is a song called Jigsaw.
Someone to see well done, someone to see good job. Well, it's not for me. Don't need no one to hold my hand through this quest of life. See if I am wrong, or begrudge me if I'm right. But don't get me wrong with all my friend. Your knowledge is in my head. I need stories about too long. Put a tree in my breath. But why don't you piece what you can say? That thing at the back of your mind, that thing is hacking away. Everything in every mind. Find my way till I'm standing in that dark with the one hand holding on tonight and one today. It's all you do what you need, be what you want. Leave it in your den if you don't need it in your bag. But I've got the view to get me home, means to get me that fire in my soul. And the lighter in my hand, I've been screamed, but I've been sold. Listen to myself, my one and only man. You can meet me who I am, but you toss a coin to break my path, to even out my odds, to face the beast being blind. So you can leave me in your head. I'm gone lost to find my way. So I'm standing in that dark with the one hand holding on tonight and once a day. I take my time to reach the kind of slow talking. Slowly things have turned me down. It's fast thinking. Through the day I missed the way that I was. One hand holding on tonight and once a day. We'll be right back.
Ladies and gentlemen, the absolutely brilliant Ryan Sheridan here tonight on the Lockup Live. Yeah, you had one of those moments. You had a Gene Butler moment. You had one of these. Is that energy and that zest that comes off you that I've always admired you as a live performer? And I think this is something that we don't see enough of. And if you've just tuned into the Lockup Live for the first time, keep us on air. Get donating right now. We want to keep Irish music out there for you to check out and tell your friends about as well. Josepha McGettigan, if you are watching this minister, we want you to invite you to come down here and meet the crew.
Hey!
At a distance, come down here and see the brilliant stuff that we're doing with Irish music. Ryan, a great privilege and pleasure to have you here. Your current single is out at the moment, Call My Name. I've seen the video, it's absolutely beautiful. Tell me a bit about this.
Yeah, I decided that I had called my name for a little while, and I decided that during the lockdown I wanted to put something out, and it hasn't been released yet, so I decided to put it out and do a video to it. So I done a kind of a lockdown video of my kind of daily routine with the kids and stuff. So yeah, go check it out. You'll kind of see what the crack is, but it was good fun.
Would we say that you have kids or that you have terrorists? Because if we look at it this way, you've got a. Last time I spoke to you, you had a 2.5-year-old. 5 years have passed.
Yes.
And you got a six and a half-year-old maybe, and a 2.5-year-old.
A 3-year-old. 3-year-old. Yeah, Toby and Bobby. Where are they? I hope you.
If you're watching, boys.
You're watching.
Brazen as ever, I'd say. So you came off the Love and War tour, which is in Germany.
Yeah.
And obviously you have to come home and lock down for a while.
Yeah.
So what has it been like, being locked down at home with the kids, or terrorists, whichever you want to call them?
I mean, it's been great. I mean, you know, like everybody, there's been up and down days, you know, but we've done loads of things. You know, I've done games last 5 minutes in our house, as you should well know. 5 minutes and then on to something else, then I'm building the fort, and then you're doing something else and you're trying to write. But I'm busy as well. Like, I'm working from home as well, and I'm producing the next album as well, so I'm doing stuff from the house in the studios too.
You, to me, have always been a phenomenal grafter. I mentioned it earlier on in the introduction. For those of you that don't know Ryan's history, 7 years of age, playing the fiddle, your mum played accordion, your dad played the banjo.
You're well informed.
I'm telling you.
You're well informed.
If you're going to get into this, do your homework. So you then, at 15, went off to do Riverdance.
I did.
And then you stayed in Broadway. So you were, like, literally writing songs in Gershwin's theatre toilet.
I did.
Tell us about that.
It was the only kind of place that was between the dressing room and the stage. So between dances, I'd run down, I'd kind of play the guitar, and then I'd be up for the next dance, and I'd drop it and run up and do the dance. I was a very professional dancer at the time.
this is the lifestyle that you led.
Well, it was good.
So literally, like, you would go on tour from one end of the year to the other, and you would only get 2 weeks off at Christmas time.
Yeah.
A lot of people don't know that about you.
That's it. Yeah, it was a long tour, and it was a year's tour, and then two weeks off at Christmas, and then you're back at it for a whole other year. So, yeah, it was good. I enjoyed it. I loved the road. You know, I really enjoy it. You know, I really enjoy touring.
For me, I think what you have that other artists don't have is this immense energy. And I think that comes from that part of your life. And you've managed to transfer that into your music, yourself and Ronan, a fabulous duo when you're together. I love to see you two together. I want to bring it on a little bit from that. So then you would have played a couple of gigs in Arlene's grocery store, which is where the Strokes kicked off.
I did, yeah.
Wow.
I did. I started playing in little clubs down the Lower East Side. Arlene's was one of them. And I just took it from there, and I just kind of stayed on. And when we finished on Broadway, I stayed on for a couple of years. I worked in a bar, and
Paddy Riley's.
You are very good.
I'm telling you, Cher is professional.
Paddy Riley's. And that was it. Just wrote songs and played down there, and that was it. Just kind of started it from there. It's such a melting pot, New York, you know, so I had to have some sort of way to express what I was going through. I was only 18, 19 at the time, so it was a good outlet for me. So
it's very evident in your music. You do seem quite personally. I'm going to let you guys set up for the next song, because I want to have a little chat to the guys at home. If you're watching this, a special shout out to Julie Donnelly and to Lynn. I hope you guys are well. Sent a lovely message saying, can't wait to see Ryan later on. He is absolutely brilliant. One of the best live acts that this country has ever produced. I totally agree with that. If you have a comment, remember, we are interactive. We are online on all social feeds. Hashtag the lockdown lockdown live. Lock up. Oh my God, it was going to happen at some stage. Give me a cheer for that. Hashtag the Lock Up Live Show. You can check it out there. Sorry, I'm so tired. I've been working all day. Not only that, if you want to donate, you'll see the link there as well. We are open for business, baby. Keep us on air. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Ryan Sheridan.
To the town hall, we race to the castle wall, rolling the reeds of fire where no one can see you. Now the clothes you wear are mine, you can take what you want, I'm fine with it. I don't open my windows wide, no fear of falling. Scars, we shed our bodies cold, we were never shy.
I bled, I fought, I crawled, I never let in my God fall.
You see me from it all. Yeah, I know this.
I follow all the fire that's inside of me. I follow all the signs that you made me see. I follow.
Hope everybody's doing okay at home. I know it's been a mad few months, and we haven't been playing, and yous haven't been out, and yous haven't seen gigs, but I hope tonight we can give a little bit back to yous, and yous enjoy the night. Hold on a second.
You okay?
So everybody, Ronan Nolan on drums, and
hello everybody.
Cajon over here.
Oh, hey guys, how's it going?
I'm gonna slow this one down a little bit. Give Ronan a break.
I'm fine. Don't mind him. Maybe just 3 or 4 minutes, please.
This is called Perfect Storm.
Thank you.
jealous lover. We keep falling back to this, the perfect storm that's over. Holding on, then letting go.
Thank you, everybody.
Oh, my love.
Thanks, everybody. So, let me see what we got here now. Okay.
So as I was saying to Fergal earlier, we've released this song called Call My Name, and there's a little video to it that I've made at home, and it's about kind of the lockdown situation, so if you want to go and check it out, this is it. This is called Call My Name. We'll give it a shot. How's everybody doing?
Great.
Everybody all right?
Great.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
Great.
Let's do it.
Sign.
On the Lock Up Live, Mr. Ryan Sheridan. Yeah! Thank you so much for all your comments in tonight. You've been sending them in using the hashtag The Lock Up Live Show. We're going to get to the comments very, very shortly. Right now, if you're out there, you're watching this and you're enjoying this show, keep us on air. By all means, donate. Go ahead and get us a sponsor. We don't mind. We'll take it. We'll take it all. We just want to keep this show going. We want to keep supporting Irish acts, just like Ryan, getting back to these shows. Thank you so much for coming down tonight, because it has been a great privilege.
It's great to be here. Honestly, great to be here.
What I like about this, Ryan, is when bands come on here, we get to tell their story, and we get to kind of look at some of the pinnacle points of their life. And one of those points was back on Grafton Street, busking,
yeah.
And a certain gentleman called Brian Whitehead fires a card into your case.
He did.
And that's where, and it just said, call me on it.
Yeah.
And that was the start of this amazing journey, really.
It really was, and it was so quick as well. I mean, we took off straight away. We started playing gigs straight away, because we weren't used to playing gigs, so we were just playing on the street. But I mean, busking was a great school for us, you know, because I was playing new songs, and what you do, like, you have to play to keep the crowd. So if the crowd stays, you know that song works. If they leave, you have to ditch that song and play another one. So it was a great schooling for me.
It's funny. I always think of Jigsaw, because for me, I've never heard that song played live the same way twice. And this is the beauty of it. You always kind of riff off each other, and I think that brings the live gig to life, which is really, really important for our listeners at home. And a lot of comments are coming in saying that. Before I get to them, your first number one in Germany. This is a wonderful story, because you are a handyman as well, and a lot of people forget that you're a family man. You're at home, you're fixing a washing machine, you're up to your hips in water, and you get a phone call from the manager saying, you're number one in Germany.
I know, yeah. I had my head in the washing machine.
Yeah.
My head was in the washing machine, trying to fix it, and then I got, he said, yeah, album went number one. I was like, what?
Yeah.
What? So, yeah, but that's it.
They're the moments you live for, though.
Absolutely, I mean, at the end of the day, we play music, and that's the main thing, you know. And we play music, and I'm a family man, and that comes first. And you know, there's no big airs and graces. It's just you get out there and play, you know. And that's it.
Yeah. There's a wonderful comment that comes in here, and it comes in from Bernie, and she says, "I saw Ryan Sheridan perform to one of the biggest crowds ever, and he was the best person on the day. This was playing for Barack Obama to 80,000 people in the streets."
Wow.
I remember that moment. I remember 80,000 people in the streets. What did that feel like?
We were busking that day.
Right.
I think we were busking that day. And then we went up on that stage.
Yeah.
And, you know, so Daniel Day-Lewis I'd be a huge fan of Daniel Day-Lewis. So we were all backstage, and Daniel Day-Lewis was there, and Brendan Gleeson, and I was just, what's going on here, you know?
And they're all looking at you going, oh God, it's Ryan Sheridan.
They are, I'm sure they are, yeah.
the Monaghan maestro was here.
Yeah, no, it was amazing. It was an amazing day. It was absolutely amazing day. I met the man himself, and one to remember, definitely.
This is a fun fact that not many people know about Ryan, is that you were the first person ever to play Crow Park and the Aviva on the same day. On the same goddamn day.
Yeah.
How did that work out? Give him a cheer for that.
Oh, thanks very much, thanks very much.
So how did that come about?
I have to just say that's Brian's doing, you know.
Yeah.
And I was just told where to go.
Yeah.
So we played Crow Park and played the halftime Crow Park, and then flew over. It was a football match, and they even played there as well. So it was mental.
People do not know your energy. Even when I'm around you, I can feel the energy of you. I'm going to let you guys get ready for the next song. Come in on these comments if you want. Loads of comments from you guys at home. Thank you so much. Keep sending them in. Hashtag The Lock Up Live Show. Simple as that. Beautiful comment from Maddie here. He's in Italy at the moment watching the show, saying, definitely TV program of the year, worldwide, amazing quality, top quality production, and the best Irish acts. I'm loving it, lads. Fair play to the crew. Big shout out to the crew here. They're all here giving their time up for free, so thank you to the crew. Another one here from Andrea Kay. She just says in German, what I can read is, just gets loose, which I'd imagine means let's get loose. In my head.
Sure.
If it doesn't mean that, I'm just delighted that you sent it anyway. It sounds good and vibrant and all that jazz. Keep up those comments. Another one from Lauren Corey. I saw Ryan at the Trinity Ball many, many moons ago. He was exceptional. I'm now bobbing around my bedroom here. Thank you so much for tonight, Lock Up Live crew and Ryan. I'm absolutely loving this. And Sabine Kay says, I have no more standing in the dark. I have your music in my blood and my soul. Cannot wait for you guys to get to Germany. Now, that's happening in October, God willing.
Yeah, hopefully. German tour, hopefully. Love and War tour is happening in October. Fingers crossed.
Well, let's keep the finger on the pulse. Ryan, the best of luck. Time for another few songs.
Thanks,
here.
Fergal.
And watch out for a song. The second song Ryan's going to play is called Home. Have a listen to this one, because this is quite prevalent in the times right now. This is The Lock Up Live. Send us your comments. And this is Mr. Ryan Sheridan.
Thanks, buddy.
I was planning my escape when you were already gone. And I knew when I was running what I'm running from. Front door slammed, I ran out the back. Left an empty house, it was under attack. Walking on the roof of a house of cards. We were stuck like glue and we were falling apart. Tried to make a run but we circled back. It's a one-way track, one-way track.
Remember when we met first? I cannot believe my eyes. In the second hand, that I clean the week is something I can understand. Holding on to you when I was letting go. Know that I'm alive when I'm out of control. Your eyes tell the story of a thousand lies. Said I was wrong, but I knew I was right. That's in the world what we're running from. But the words don't come, the words don't come.
Remember when we met first? I cannot believe.
Guitar change here.
You're doing a wonderful job.
You're doing a wonderful job. You're pretty amazing. You're very good.
No.
He's very good.
No, he's very good.
Oh, this is the guy
he's
over here.
Very good. This boy. So, sorry, everybody.
I got it.
This is what happens at a live gig, too. So, this next song
is a song that I wrote for Mrs. Brown Boys, the movie. And you know, the song is not about a place. You know, you call it home. It's not a place, it's people. And it's people that love you and
that you love and you're comfortable around and you can be yourself around, and that's home for me. So to everybody, it's for everybody at home and missing your family and not being able to go and hug them and stuff like that there. This is for everybody. Stick with it and we'll be out of this very soon. It's called Home. I was going to call it something else, but I think home suits us. Don't you?
I think it's great, man.
Thanks.
I don't know what I'm talking about.
No one said it was easy on your own. We learned the hard way to see, chasing dreams, running miles from where you're from. To lift your feet off the ground, no one said it. Chasing dreams, running miles from
to lift your feet off the ground.
Thanks, everybody.
Absolutely loving that, Ryan.
Ah, thanks, Fergal.
That is one of my favorite songs by Ryan Sheridan. If you're just after tuning in, it's The Lock Up Live. Thank you so much to everyone who's tuned in tonight, everyone who's donated. I just forgot, I didn't bring along any paper, so that invitation I gave for the Minister of Culture, I didn't get a chance to actually give her a physical copy. No. So if you're at home and you're watching in, if you wouldn't mind taking out your phone and helping a brother out, and just sending a little tweet, at Josepha Madigan, tell her the guys from The Lock Up Live want her to come down and check out our studio. I think that's fair enough, isn't it? Yeah, come on. Come down and check out some of the great Irish talent we have here. We're making sure that people are getting their fix. So come down and have a little look. That song there, that was in Mrs. Brown's Boys.
Yes.
The movie. Now, you have a very interesting story about when you met Brendan O'Connor. Yeah.
I did. Yeah. Brendan O'Carroll, he was...
Brendan O'Carroll, sorry, I only keep saying Brendan. Sorry, Brendan O'Carroll.
Brendan O'Carroll, yeah. I did. He asked me that. He was shooting the movie at the time. And I came down to meet him about talking about the song and where it was at. And I knocked on his trailer, and I opened the trailer. It was Mrs. Brown was standing there in her underwear, fully.
Nice.
Yeah.
And it was very strange, I have to say. Like, though he didn't break character at all, you know. He had the. Oh, it was amazing. So.
Well, this is quite fitting because you see that was payback and karma working away, because when Ryan Sheridan was playing in the Point Depot, support to Brian Adams, Brian happened to be in his jocks in his changing room, and Brian Adams, one of the guys who you looked up to from the age of 10, if not younger, arrives on a skateboard and goes, "How's it going, buddy?" in your changing room.
I'll never forget it. Sorry, I'm taking this water all the time, but no, I'll never forget it. I was getting changed, getting ready for the show, and we were just after sound check, and just standing in me boxers, and the door was closed. It automatically locks, you know?
Yeah.
And I thought it was one of the boys trying to get back in. So, boop, boop, boop on the door. And I open the door, and it's Brian Adams standing in a skateboard. And I'm standing in me jacks.
I mean, is it not as random as it gets for an artist to arrive on a skateboard? Like, it's not priority when it comes to safety in the Point Depot, is it?
No. He was just floating around, flying around, and I was just standing there. This is the first time I'm meeting him, and I'm standing there in my boxers.
Wow.
Oh, absolutely.
I love these stories, and that's what The Lock Up Live is all about. Bringing these stories to you guys. A lot of people giving shout-outs for the crew. Let's hear it for our wonderful crew tonight. Some lovely comments coming in. John Lawler is in Monaghan at the moment. He says, "Ryan, you're playing a blinder, but would you ever buy Ronan Nolan a towel?" Niamh Dorse and Shaw's got in contact saying this is the best part of our lockdown. George Murphy, another fabulous Irish artist, we'll all agree on that. George has got in contact saying amazing job, Ryan.
Thanks, guys.
George, absolutely
thanks, George.
Great appreciate you getting back. Felix Schmidt has got in contact. He says, "I saw Ryan." Now, this could be something. "I saw Ryan in Germany 3 years ago. I instantly tried to learn his songs on the guitar, and it would be my dream to play with him on stage when he comes on tour in October."
Cool.
Maybe something we can...
Oh, we could arrange.
We'll have
something.
A little look. We'll have a look. We're not going to promise anything now, Felix. But cool. We'll have a look. We'll have a little look.
Absolutely.
And Mags Garvey has got in contact saying that she loves the relationship between Ryan and Nolan, which I think we all in the room do.
Thanks, Mags.
They're absolutely brilliant. Listen, come here. Just so you know, if you want to check out that song, it's called Call My Name. It is up online. Also, check out Ryan online. Ryan, thank you so much for your time.
I absolutely enjoyed it. Loved it, both of us. It's great to be out.
If you want to get ready for your final song, ladies and gentlemen, this is Mr. Ryan Sheridan. Tell your friends about this, and don't forget, keep us on air, please. We've got the High Kings tomorrow night. Remember to check that out, very important. And if you fancy donating, the link is just below. From me, Fergal Darcy, this is Ryan Sheridan. Good night.
the boat ready.
Thanks everybody for tuning in. Thanks everybody for tuning in. Thanks to the crew. Thanks to Lock Up Live for having us. It's been phenomenal to be able to come back and play. It's been so long for us playing live. So we hope to see us all soon again. And hopefully in October we go ahead with the tour and then some Irish dates as well by the end of the year, hopefully. Big shout out to my mother and father that's watching and my little boys and Sue and the whole shebang. And we're going to leave you with this last one, and it's called The Dreamer.
I just can't keep a thing. Sick and tired of the situation I'm in, and I'm sick of the bills that are weighing me down. Plus they couldn't wait, took the chance in the 64. It's my luck, it doesn't rain on me, it falls. They know they got a one way to get the hell in. If I was half the man that I'd try to be, with my demons stirred to some degree, yeah. The only way I'm going is up. City that tell me down, and people shake my hand all over town, and my face on a board saying vote me number one. Oh, 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 oh. A 1, 2, 3, 4. This is for the dream. I move it, do it, lose it. I'm home. Don't tell me money's nothing. Look around, can't get a job, and I work to live, but don't live to work. Boom, with my lucky penny swinging round my neck. If I was half the man that I'd try to be, with my demons stirred to some degree, the only way I'm going now is up. It's my time to shine in the picket line, and my letters big on my picket sign. Get your hands up. Whoa, 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 whoa. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is for the dream. I move it, do it, lose it. I'm home. We'll be right back.
Thanks for tuning in. Thanks, crew. Thanks, Lock Up.